to another exciting new week of the Erongo Talk. My name is Lena Ndakevonjo, and today we're joining you from the Swakopmund Guest House here in Swakopmund. For our interview section, we'll be talking to the chairperson of the Overherero Genocide Federation, who will be telling us about the discussion that happened during the 1904 between the Overherero and Namakwa genocide. But first up is our calendar day, so stay tuned and don't go anywhere. It's now time for a news update. Residents of the Tamariske voice their discontent about sewage water spilling into their premises and homes. Upon visiting Brokkerhof land, a resident who opted to remain anonymous said that the Swakopmund municipality should buy her house as the damage caused by the sewage water is irreparable. According to this resident, her daughter-in-law has written countless letters to the Swakopmund municipality asking for them to solve the matter. Municipality Public Relations Officer Eileen Gabbard said the municipality is currently renovating the pipe system in the town. She also urged the public not to throw objects into the sewage system as it can block the entire system. In our second story, from February to August, more than 739 suspects have been arrested in connection with drug-related crimes, and more than 94% of them are Namibian. The Namibian police seized various types of drugs last month, valued at more than 800,000, while 92 suspects were arrested in connection with drug-related crimes. Of the suspects, 86 are Namibian, 3 Angolan, and 2 Congolese, while a Tanzanian national was also arrested. This includes 78.35 kg of cannabis to the value of 780 million Mandrax tablets worth 25,680 and 41 grams of cocaine powered value at 20,500. According to statistics from the Namibian police, from February to August, drugs to the value of more than 21.57 million were confiscated in Namibia. In our third story, a 39-year-old man died in a motor vehicle accident that occurred onto the B2 road between Usakos and Arandas. Deputy Commissioner Erastus Ikuu, Regional Crime Investigation Coordinator, confirmed the incident happened on Saturday at about 22:37. He said that a Volvo truck with two trailers carrying an asset bag with a 39-year-old Namibian male driver being the only occupant was traveling onto the B2 from Usakos towards Arandas. The deceased was employed by Coleman Transport. His body was taken to Swakopmund State Hospital mortuary for death certification and further handling. His next of kin have not been informed yet, and the investigation continues. But stay tuned for more of our news updates.
I'm joined here by Omo Ingona Wahimitha Kapehi. How are you doing today?
Very good. How are you?
I'm doing very well. So, recently, obviously, we have the issue or the topic of the genocide of 1904 of the Overherero and the Namakwa people has been trending. And there has also been a lot of debate and discourse in parliament, and you were also one of the people that witnessed what was happening there. Tell us more about what has been the latest discussions on the genocide.
What happened actually is that the agreement, the joint agreement between the Namibia and the federal German government is now that bring confusions in the Namibian people, especially with the affected community. As you know that there was a committee which was led by our late Dr. Gadirwe, let me rest in power. And that committee, it did its part. And as I was at the other committee, of course, I'm representing the other committee, the OGF, which was led by our paramount chief, Bekwe Rukoro, and that also is all rest in power. Now, currently, this joint agreement, it happened that the leadership also of the Hereros in different families, it happened that also those who were in the agreement with the committee that was negotiating this whole deal, also our chief, Chief Derewa and Chief Maharero, they pull out also for the deal, which is also give also an certain that something's going wrong.
Yes.
And also that the affected community, the Nama and the Hero, which this side also now, they join together. So what me as a person and a chairperson at the coastal area, I'm requesting also that these groups, the Hereros and the Nama, they must come together. And when they stand together, all of them, I think we will have a good direction. But we have, if we are divided, then we are fall.
Yeah.
So now currently, this issue was tabled in the parliament, and we was having a demonstration when it was tabled. I think it was on the 7th, here in, also in Swakopmund, at the monument, which is in front of our parliament in Swakopmund, where we were saying that we stand firm as community and reject the deal, because in the deal, it's not going to assist us. There's nothing that we are saying. The genocide is not mentioned. They did not recognize what we want. So, and all the people were not on at the table by that time. So now, it's why we say now we reject the deal. Let's start as fresh. Let's come together. Let's do these things together.
From the beginning.
Hmm.
So, obviously, how has the death of Dr. Z. Ngavirwe, who's a special envoy for the representing Namibia, and also the late paramount chief, Dr. Bekwe Rukoro, affected this? And can you also tell us, has there been any apology, and what are they also offering in this reparations?
No, in this agreement, they mention apology, just be mentioned. The president of Germany must come to Namibia with the president, and the foreign affairs minister must come. They have to come, and then, because now these things was passed in the parliament 2006 by Chief Kwame Ariwago by that time. So, and there's three pillars, and in these three pillars is not in the document of the agreement, of the joint agreement. So, and there's a lot of interpretation now in the document, because now people has playing with words now.
Yeah.
And now you jump from reparation, and now you are talking about atrocity. You understand? So there's something that now, these things now, people now, is when they say now, you can give us, in the document they say, it's for the project. And this money is for 30 years. And we have a lot of educated people, and we know how to do this. And German government know also how to do it, because they did it when they pay the judge. And also, we want the money to come, and then we decided where to put it, because we can even put in the World Bank like the judge. It's why the judge is the rich people in the world. They put the money, and then they get the interest, and then they decided what to do with their money.
Yes.
But now this money is been decided by the killer, which is the German, and the government, which the government going to change tomorrow. If this government change tomorrow, well, who's going to take this responsibility?
Yes.
So now, why the affected community, they can run their own affair. You see, and it doesn't mean that if we decided that we have to build a road, it can benefit everyone in Namibia. If we build a university or we build a clinic, it can benefit, but it must come from us.
The decision on what the money must be spent on must come from the people affected.
The people affected. And we want to buy farms. We want to go back to our farms where we originally was pushed out by these German soldiers and the German government. So how can we go there? And we want to do things peacefully. Yes. So if we can go there, then we have to buy. So it seems now this money come, we buy from the German, the money go back to German. So and the, now you say now you, we must build these roads and the of the university. And we don't have the contractor, a heavy contractor that you have for all this material. Where can you get it? Yeah. Again from German, it go back to German.
So it's a whole cycle.
So it's a cycle, this thing, you understand. Yeah. But we as affected community, we want land. We want the cattle, and we want all these the resources which was taken from us
during the war.
Yeah, during those war. And you know that our history, our holy fires, these things must be we must come back. You see, we must live in that old virgin, so that now we know that me as I'm sitting here, my parents was raped. Where what happened? So that now I can be born. I have a German blood and a Rome blood as I'm sitting here. So I cannot run away from that. But the German father, now today, he forget about that. He's having the son in the Rome people. So now how will I feel? But the German people which is in Swakopmund, here where I'm living, they don't see me as a brother or as a sister. Because they don't recognize. And now, they are the one benefiting from the money that they get from Germany, from the plot or from the farm where they are sitting. They push me out. You understand? Now they are benefiting. Their kids have been taken to the good school, high schools. Their kids have been taken to Germany for the university and whatever. While I'm suffering, the government cannot decide on us and put term for reference on top of us while what we want. That's the framework from the beginning. That's what we're supposed to do. You understand? But we were not part of the framework of saying how can we do this process and going forward.
Okay. Well, this debate is going to go on, and I'm sure the Herero people and the Namakwa people are probably also looking for their own special lawyers to represent them. To maybe take it to the Hague or to any other international court?
Yes, we are in process. But you know that there was also part of the hero that took the case to the court in America. And that case is now is ended. You know that the lawyer was here in Swakopmund, I think 2 years ago. All of them that were representing our case. So, but unfortunately, that because of, you know, that is also superpowers, so they are playing with words and whatever. But they have to remember that our land is here in Namibia. The farms is here. And one day, if they are pushing us, we can go back where we belong. And when we go back where we belong, someone which is sitting there, he must move out.
So thank you very much. That was Omwingona Wahimitha Kapehi here on Erongo Talk. Keep on watching Erongo Talk.
The municipality of Maruru, and natives, we have a marriage of which the certificate is very much alive. Momentarily, the NATIS operations are being conducted at the municipal headquarters in Omaruru. In the past, we saw Omaruru having its own NATIS testing center, fully equipped, cars, vehicles were tested here, licenses, driver's license, learner's license were also tested here in Omaruru. And it is our wish to reactivate the operations of the testing center. Now, as council, momentarily what is happening is that the NATIS, the building, it is being utilized by the traffic department for our town. Now what we have said, what we've committed ourselves as council is that we've allocated one of the council's houses in order for the traffic department to move out of the NATIS center in order for NATIS, for RA, that has been after consultations. We had consultations with RA. They even came to Omaruru, the Deputy Minister of Works and Transport, as well as the Minister of Works and Transport. We are also in negotiations and in full conversation also with them, and we want to also take a trip to Windhoek either to also invite them to Omaruru for us to have a very advantageous dialogue, because we want at least the Omaruru NATIS center to be fully fledged operational. So that is the relationship with us. Momentarily, from the fruitful talks that we had with the RA's executives, is that at least they are in the capacity to come to Omaruru while we are waiting for the full renovation of the current NATIS center, which is not operational. They are in the capacity to come to Omaruru because we need at least 15 million to have a fully functional center. Momentarily, in the interim, they are willing to come to Omaruru to start with the learners testing, because with the learners, you would not need a fully functional, full-fledged functioning center, of which we have a building that we have also allocated for that use. Simultaneously, concurrently, we have also supported, we have availed the community hall to be used, as it's next to our people, it's quite central. So we have also allocated the community hall to be used for such examinations. And they have, the RA have also committed, at least this year, 2021, to also bring that new technology, so that we can start the replication and of expired driver's license, meaning the current disadvantageous state of when your driver's license expires, you are forced to drive to Karipep, you are forced to drive to Chuvarongo, you are forced to drive to Kahanje Swakopmund. That is going to become history, the story of the past. So at least they are also willing to come to Omaruru with that newly advanced technology.
Positive news indeed.
Yeah. Also to add, we have a situation, the Omaruru Bridge. A lot of people, when you are in transit to the north, you would notice that our bridge, the size is a little bit disadvantageous. So, talks are also so that we can expand the bridge. However, we shall revert back to our people should all this be realized and be fruitful.
It's now time for our sports updates. Local favorite Ellen Martin, along with his navigator Margaretha, emerged victorious at the 2021 Namco Swakop Rally. The Duke clocked a time of 55 in their scooter. Martin expressed his delight at scooping first prize. According to the ace racer, he experienced butterflies in his stomach for the first time and his foot was jumping off the pedal. Over 19 vehicles raced through 8 stages of the adrenaline-packed event, which started at the soon-to-be-open Namco server station in Swakopmund before ending near the Swakop go-karts track. There were 4 categories competing, namely S1, S2, S3 and S4, 2 for the challenge class, CR1 and CR2, CR3 class consisting of 4-wheel and 2-wheel Bakkies. The rally is part of the Namibian National Championship, of which this was leg 2 of 6 spread over a time frame of 2 years due to COVID-19 regulation. In our second story, Blue Waters face Civics while Mighty Gunners renew their rivalry against Young Africans in the semi-finals of the MTC NFA Cup away to be contested at Stadium in Gobabis on the 16th of October in 2021. This came about after a recent draw with the Namibian Football Association flagship competition heading into the Final Four. Blue Waters came through the previous two rounds with victorious via penalty shootouts, while Civics defeated Q's FC 3-0 in the quarterfinals. Mighty Gunners lost to African Stars in 2013 and then to Young African in 2017 in the final of the same competition. In total, the MTC NFA Cup away has seen 99 goals scored since the round of 32. MTC sponsors the NFA with 4.5 million annually for the FA Cup for the next 3 years. The tournament winners go home with 500,000 and the runner-ups with 250,000, while the third and fourth place teams receive 150,000 and 100,000 respectively. With that said, we've come to the end of our news for today. For more news headline, visit our website at www.erongo.com.na.
Good day, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Melissa and I am a red belt Kyokushin Karateka. Today's self-defense tip. Let's say you're walking down the street and you get attacked. It's always important to remember the body's sensitive areas. So these are the neck, the throat, esophagus area right here, the groin area over here, and as well as the back over here. So these are the places that you can punch or kick in order to get your opponent going down, and that's when you run away. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Stay safe.
Today, Wildfish Bay is expected to have a maximum temperature of 24 with a minimum of 15 and a maximum of 22 degrees for tomorrow. The wind is expected to blow from the west-northwesterly direction with a speed of 11 kilometers per hour, sunrise at 06:33, sunset at 19:04. For Swakopmund, the maximum temperature is expected to be 21 degrees with a minimum of 15 and a maximum of 21 degrees for tomorrow. The wind is expected to blow from the west direction with a speed of 9 kilometers per hour. Sun rose at 06:34, sunset at 19:04. for Hendy's Bay, the maximum temperature is expected to be 21 degrees with a minimum of 15 and a maximum of 21 degrees for tomorrow. The wind is expected to blow from the west-northwesterly direction with a speed of 19 kilometers per hour. Sun rose at 06:32, sunset at 19:05. For Arandas, the maximum temperature is expected to be 38 degrees with a minimum of 13 and a maximum of 35 degrees for tomorrow. The wind is expected to blow from the west-northwesterly direction with a speed of 19 kilometers per hour. Sun rose at 06:32, sunset at 19:02. For Osakos, the maximum temperature is expected to be 40 degrees with a minimum of 16 and a maximum of 40 degrees for tomorrow. The wind is expected to blow from the east direction with a speed of 13 kilometers per hour. Sun rose at 06:30, sunset at 7 o'clock. For Karibab, the maximum temperature is expected to be 39 degrees with a minimum of 60 and a maximum of 39 degrees for tomorrow. The wind is expected to blow from the east direction with a speed of 15 kilometers per hour. Sun rose at 06:29, sunset at 2 minutes to 7. For Maruru, the maximum temperature is expected to be 39 degrees with a minimum of 15 and a maximum of 39 degrees for tomorrow. The wind is expected to blow from the east direction with a speed of 15 kilometers per hour. Sun rose at 06:29, sunset at 2 minutes to 7.
With that said, we've come to the end of our news for today. For more news headlines, visit our website at www.irongo.com.na. And if you have any video clips and would like to share with us, contact us via our WhatsApp number at 0811700040. And remember, strive for progress and not for perfection. So from me to you, enjoy the rest of your week. So ciao!